I live by a golden rule in my family. And I have it tattooed on my forearm. And the golden rule is, love your neighbor as yourself, right? And I changed that a little bit, just because I don't think it's tough enough for me. It's just weird to have a tattoo that says, you know, love your neighbor. You know, it's just for me, it's not what I want. So, for me it says, no man shall live for himself. And that golden rule, I raised my three boys in there. And someone, I was listening to a TED talk the other day, and it was a phenomenal talk, and here's what was said, and this is what I took from it, because I think Lazarex is this. This person said, whatever you wish for, whatever you hate, or whatever you fear, figure out a way. If you fear it, figure out a way to eliminate it for your neighbor. If you hate it, figure out a way to get rid of it for your neighbor. And if you wish it, figure out a way to make that wish possible for your neighbor. And it meant a lot to me when it came to this. Because I'll be the first, I'll be honest with you, when I saw the word cancer whip across my dad's forehead, I feared it. That scares me. And so I was willing to do whatever it took to make sure that fear was eliminated from my father and from my family. Because I would not want to have that. I don't want to fear it, so I'm going to eliminate it. And I want to create boldness and courage. And I think Lazarus does that. And I hate cancer. Because it kills people. And it hurts families. And it wounds them. And it takes their mommies. And it takes their daddies. And I got three boys that are 6, 3, and 1. And I don't want to. And I'll be perfectly honest with you. They need to outlive me. So I don't want it, so I fear it, and I hate it, and I want to create ways to get rid of that. And I don't wish it upon anyone. And I don't think any of you wish it upon anybody. And that's what I think this organization is built for, it's destined for. And I'm so thankful for you, for your passion, and it's incredible. And I'm starting to hurt here, so I gotta tell this story. But I want to leave you with one thing. If you could do me a favor, can you all put your hand to your neck and feel your pulse? Can you feel it? So someone, it's not a trick question. You can repeat it because I've already said it. Can anybody tell me what that is?
Life.
Life.
That's purpose. It is life. If you have a pulse, you have a purpose. You all have a purpose. And if this patient makes a phone call and says they haven't been given hope, they have a pulse, they have a purpose. And our job as human beings is to sustain that purpose in that human being and every human being around us, because we are all destined for greatness. And I'm a 2-time World Series champion. It means absolutely nothing if I don't help create purpose in another human being.